With the Noonan Coweta Humane Society. And what our group does is we come down here to Coweta County Animal Control, located off of Selt Road, that's S-E-L-T in Noonan. And we showcase as many of their cats, dogs, puppies, and kittens as we can get on in this segment in hopes that someone out there watching the show will want to rush on down and adopt a pet. Now, folks, I want to mention really quickly, in case you're one of those people that's just flipping channels and you're not going to stay tuned, which I hope you do anyway, but I do want to mention that we are doing a huge fundraiser for our organization. We are trying to get our own shelter. This is not our shelter. This is animal control. We come here and we showcase the pets, but it's not our own standalone shelter, and we're raising money right now. If you want to help us out, please do visit our website at nchsrescue.org, and hopefully you can help us get to our goal to have the first no-kill shelter in Coweta County. But right now, please stay tuned, and we hope that you enjoy this show. And guys, we want to start off this show today with this sweet little girl. This is Spice. She is a gorgeous calico kitty. And I tell you what, out of all the cats we have here, this little girl is one of the cleanest cats. She keeps her cage perfectly pristine and clean. So we know that's the way she's going to be in your home as well. Now, little Spice here is in C7. And this girl was picked up as a stray from Roberts Road, but she is available for adoption now. We believe she's maybe about a year old, possibly could still be a kitten because she's very small, but I don't have her age on her ID card, so I really don't know, but the vet here at Animal Control can certainly verify that for you. She's absolutely stunning though. Look at how pretty she is. Look at those gorgeous, gorgeous markings. And I love her sweet little face. Oh my goodness, now she's gonna hang her little head. But she's just scared, folks. She's a very petite kitty. I don't think she's gonna get much bigger. She's very petite and very, very sweet and just scared. You know, this little kitty's in this great big world and she doesn't know what in the world's going on. But if you're interested in Spice, please do hurry on down here to Animal Control and rescue this gorgeous girl. She's down here just waiting for you. Hey guys, we have a cute little dude here. So his nickname is Doolittle. This little honey is a poodle, a mini poodle mix, and it looks like he's hanging out in B5. He is blonde. He definitely needs some grooming. So, you know, you need to be prepared to give him a good bath and a good grooming. But I tell you what, he has got the greatest little personality, and this little stub of his little tail just been wagging. He is so happy to be out here and be playing with us. This little cutie pie was picked up as a stray from Young Avenue. No collar, no ID. And he is approximately 2 years old, but I tell you what, he has already won us over for sure. So we know this boy is not gonna last long. If you want to add Doolittle to your family, you better hurry on down here to Animal Control, because I tell you what, I think we've already got a couple of volunteers with their eye on him. So come on down and rescue little Doolittle. This little boy is just waiting to fill your heart and your home with lots of love. Folks, I tell you what, this little boy is so stinking sweet, and he's so cute. He's extremely affectionate. He practically jumps out of the cage into your arms. He's purring up a storm. He's got a little purr as loud as a lion and a heart as big as a lion too. But this is little Roscoe, and Roscoe is a tabby, as you can see, and I cannot believe he has not been adopted yet. He hasn't been here that long. He's only been here about a month. But I think he's getting overlooked simply because he's just a tabby and people just look him over. But I tell you what, this boy will make your life so much better and so much happier and fill you with so much joy because he's such a love and so sweet. Little Roscoe's hanging out in C2, and he is only about 2 or 3 months old. And this little buddy is was picked up as a stray from Roscoe Road, hence his name Roscoe. But I tell you what, he's just purring in my ear, and he is just so sweet. He gives kisses. He'll kiss your little face and love on you and just purr his way right on into your heart. I tell you what, he is something special. So you've got to get down here and get this boy before somebody pulls him out of the cage and realizes what a sweetheart he is, because he's not going to last long after that. Somebody's going to take him home, and they're just going to be so happy for it. So come on down and rescue little Roscoe. He's down here just waiting for you. And guys, we are having so much fun with this boy here. This is Buddy, and he is a buddy. He's ready to be your buddy. I tell you what, if you have a child and you want them to grow up with a little puppy by their side, this would be the perfect addition. Little Buddy here is a terrier mix. He's white and brown, just as handsome as he can be. He's hanging out in B9, that's his kennel number, and he was picked up as a stray from LaGrange Street. They scanned him, no ID. They don't have his age on the card, but obviously he's still a puppy. He's probably just a couple months old. And oh my goodness, we love this boy. He is just so, so precious. He's still got lots of puppy energy, of course, and loves to just chew on everything, but I would too if I had those little puppy teeth. But I tell you what, Buddy here is gonna make such a wonderful addition to somebody's family, and I know that you will love him as much as we do. But we want to make sure that Buddy gets a good home. So come on down here and rescue Buddy and give this little sweetheart a forever home. Hey folks, we have a real sweetheart here. This is Freeway. And Freeway, of course, was found on the highway, on Highway 34. This little boy is only, gosh, they have marked it only 10 weeks old. He's a tiny little thing. Jet black, absolutely handsome as he can be. He does seem to have longer hair, so I think he's going to be more of a medium hair to long haired kitty cat. But this little handsome fella is hanging out in C15. That is his cat condo number. And just as gorgeous and sweet as he can be. Oh my goodness, if you could just see how shiny and pretty his fur is. He's so healthy. Look at him making those little biscuits. He loves me scratching his little back. He's making the little air biscuits with his paw. But Freeway here is so ready to find his new forever home, and we are hoping that you'll take this boy home and make Freeway a free bird. This boy needs to be free, and he needs to be in somebody's house where he can hang out and have fun and play all day long. So come on down and rescue Freeway. And guys, we have a sweet, sweet girl that is just so scared. I mean, her back legs are just shaking, and every once in a while, she'll give us a little tail wag, but she is very, very nervous, and who can blame her? This pretty, pretty girl just got lost and ended up here at Animal Control, and now she just doesn't know what in the world to do. This is Vicky, and Vicky is a black mouth cur. She's got this gorgeous sable brown coat, and then she's got the black around her snout, which is the trademark kind of markings for the black mouth cur. Of course, she's a mix because we don't know for sure if she's mixed in with something else, another breed. But this pretty girl was picked up as a stray from Lassiter Road. No collar, no ID. She's hanging out in B1. That's her kennel number. She's about 2 years old, and she's had her shot. She's been dewormed. I do have to mention that they do have her card marked heartworm positive, but that is not the end of the road for Miss Vicky. She has lots of life ahead of her. My goodness, she's only two. And that the fact that she's heartworm positive is something that is highly treatable by a veterinarian. And then once they get rid of the heartworm, she can get her on a heartworm preventative so that you don't have to deal with that ever again. But I tell you what, this girl is worth all of that. I mean, it's not that much trouble, honestly. Just a couple trips to the vet and then it's all taken care of. But she needs a home and she needs to get out of here soon just because she's so scared. But she is so sweet. As you can see, she loves being really close to us. She'll stay really close to your side and certainly be your best friend. So come on down and rescue Vicky. By actually adopting this girl and rescuing her, you are saving her life. So come on down and save Vicky. And guys, we have some real cute little kittens here. There seem to be a lot of kittens all of a sudden down here, kind of an influx of them. And I've heard they're getting a lot more cats and kittens in lately. So we're gonna have to do our best to find homes for all these little sweethearts. I am holding little Sunshine, and she is the sister to these other girls. We've got Lily here in the middle, that's the gray and white, and then we've got Daffodil on the end that is also an orange tabby, but with some white. And all of these sisters have actually come from the same place, the same mom. So it's so crazy when we see these colors that, you know, the gray is all of a sudden here with the orange, but you never know what you're gonna get when your cat has kittens. But all these little sweethearts are just precious. They're all hanging out in C6. That's their kitten condo number. And all these girls were picked up as strays from Old Corinth, no ID. And you know, they can get their microchip as soon as they are spayed. So it's really good for you to go ahead when you're getting your pet spayed or neutered to go ahead and get them microchipped, because at that point they're knocked out. They don't even know what happened. The microchip really doesn't hurt them. It's kind of like just getting a shot anyway. But you really need to microchip your pets, folks, because that's the best way to be reunited should your pet become lost. And we just want to make sure that Sunshine and Lily and Little Daffodil all get homes. We would love for two of these girls to go together. I mean, gosh, if you're willing to take on three, go ahead and take on all three of these little honeys. But no matter what, even if it's just one at a time, we want to make sure they all get homes. So come on down and rescue Sunshine, Lily, and Daffodil. These little sweethearts are just waiting for you. And folks, we're having so much fun with this boy. This is Earl. He is such a sweet, sweet puppy. He's got some big paws, so he's definitely gonna grow into those, but they show him as a beagle mix, so maybe he'll just grow this way and not so much this way. But he is wonderful, and he is so loving, and I love his coloring. He's got the spots all over him, not just black spots, but he's also got brown spots too. He's got these little brown eyebrows, and oh my goodness, look at him. He just gives kisses all day long. He's so, so sweet. And he's only about 3 months old, so he's definitely got some growing to do, but he will certainly grow his way into your heart because he is a sweet, sweet boy. Now, Earl is hanging out in B19, and this handsome fella was picked up as a stray from Susie Place. And no collar, no ID, but I tell you what, he is something special. Look at him. He is just wonderful. He loves to give kisses. He's smart. He's sweet. He's just the perfect little boy. So if you're interested in Earl, hurry on down here to Animal Control and rescue this sweet boy. I tell you what, he's going to be a wonderful addition to your home and to your family, and he will love you for a lifetime. So come on down and rescue Earl. Folks, I tell you what, we have a very handsome and very sweet boy here. This is Cullen. He's jet black except for a little patch of white on his chest, a little star, and he is a lover. When our volunteer Suzanne opened up his cage, he just put his arms up on her shoulders and just wanted to be loved, and I can hear him purring. He's making air biscuits with every paw, front and back. He's just going, going. Oh my gosh, he has white on his belly too. He has a white spot on his belly that was hiding from us. Now, Cullen is only a year old, so he's still very young. He's hanging out in C11, that's his cat condo number. He is being adorned right now. He's like, all right, ladies. He's just, whoo, happy as he can be. What a very, very sweet boy. Now, Cullen was picked up as a stray from Little Road, and this handsome fella has actually been here since June, so he is certainly ready to find his forever home and to get a chance to lay in somebody else's lap and just, you know, lay the day away, just be a lazy boy, and just get lots and lots of love. And I tell you what, he's got tons and tons of love to give you in return. He keeps headbutting my hand because he doesn't want me to stop loving on him. He's such a nice cat. Look at this. What a great lap cat. I mean, who could ask for more? He's going to stay by your side and love on you all day long. So if you're looking for a very highly affectionate kitty cat, then definitely you want to come on down and adopt Cullen, because this special boy is down here just waiting for you. So come on down and adopt Cullen. And folks, there are quite a few dogs here at Animal Control that are free to the public because they've been here so long and they're such wonderful dogs and would make wonderful pets in somebody's home. The Animal Control would much rather give them away free than put them down. And this boy, Martin, is one of those dogs that is free. He has actually been here since December. And I tell you what, we were all talking about it, the fact that if we were stuck in a cage for 8 months, we would not be as happy as Martin is when you let him out. And he is just as sweet as he can be. Of course, he's very high energy, but that's only because he's been in a cage for so long and he needs to work some of that energy off. And he's only about a year old. So it's no wonder, you know, don't look at him thinking, oh, he's going to be a spaz in my home. He just needs to run and burn off all that energy. Dogs are so much happier if they can run and play and burn off lots of energy rather than being stuck in a cage. Now, Martin is in B10, and he is a white and brown terrier mix, as you can see. So we just want to make sure that he gets a home and he gets it really soon, because he really, like I said, needs to burn off that energy. So don't let that deter you from adopting him when you see him so excited. He's healthy, he's happy, and those are definitely two qualities that you want to look for in a dog. So, and he loves people. So if you're interested in Martin, please hurry on down here. Like I said, he is absolutely 100% free of the public. That will include him being neutered, his rabies shot, his microchip, all of his vaccinations. So you won't even have to take him to the vet. So that is just such a wonderful thing for this boy and for you as well. So come on down and rescue Martin and take your free dog home. Hey guys, look at this sweet little baby. Oh my goodness, this is Duke. And he looks like he has a little lopsided mustache. He's got this little white face with little black markings around his little mouth. Oh, his little heart's beating so fast, folks. He hears those dogs in the dog kennel area from right behind us really barking, and it's just scaring this little boy. Little Duke is all by himself in his cage. He's just a fluffy little fella. He's the tuxedo kitty, but also has a little bonus of a mustache on top of that. But Duke is hanging out in C29. That's his cat condo number. This little boy is probably, looking at him, he's probably only about a month old, maybe 5 weeks at the most, but definitely a little tiny baby in this great big world, so scared. He was picked up from Moore Road as a stray, scanned him, no ID, and he's got these cute little white paws, and one of our volunteers, Suzanne, said he kind of reminds her of Charlie Chaplin. He's just got that kind of look to him, but he is so adorable and so sweet. He's just purring, but of course, he's very, very scared. He's so tiny. So if you're interested in Duke, we want to see this little boy get a home as soon as possible. So come on down and rescue this little cutie pie, and I know that you're going to fall in love. He's going to love you too, and it's going to be a wonderful connection. So come on down and rescue little Duke. And folks, we have a big boy here just for you. This is Bert. Bert is he's marked as a Chow Chow mix. I don't know if that's accurate, but we know for sure that this boy is super sweet. He's a very big dog, so be prepared for a big boy. He does need to actually add a little bit of weight onto him. He's kind of skinny on his body. But super sweet. He's not even interested in the camera or anything else going on in the room. He just wants to love on Anne and myself. But Bert here is about 4 years old, and he is hanging out in A6. He was picked up as a stray from Peachtree Landing Subdivision, wearing a brown collar. So we know he was somebody's pet at one point, and somehow he got lost and ended up here at animal control. Now, I do have to mention that Bert is heartworm positive, but that is not the end of the road for this guy, folks. That is something that is highly treatable by a veterinarian, and then once they get rid of the heartworms, they can put him on a preventative, and he can be good to go. So if you're interested in Bert, he has been here since the beginning of June, so he's been here quite a while, and poor guy, he needs some brushing and some grooming to get all this summer hair off of him. It's all just sitting on him and making him even more hot in this summer sun. So he just needs a good bath and some grooming and some good food, and I tell you what, you will have a friend for life. So come on down and rescue Bert. He's down here just waiting for you. And guys, just so that you know, we do have two calico cats here right now, one named Patch, which is right here, and another one named Patches. And we're so sorry if we confuse the public by naming them such similar names, but apparently it's a popular name for a calico cat. But this one here, Patch, is hanging out in C18, and she's about 2 years old. It looks like she was actually confiscated because unfortunately somebody was evicted from their property and couldn't take the kitty with them. So now she's all kind of confused and here at animal control. So sweet Patch here is just absolutely gorgeous. I mean, these calico kitties are so pretty. They look like a patchwork quilt, and that's, you know, hence they get the name Patch or Patches. But sweet as she can be, as you can see up here on our volunteer Claudia's shoulder, pretty much hanging around. But gorgeous green eyes. I know you're not going to be able to see those because she's too busy just getting all this love and being happy and feeling secure in Claudia's arms, but what a gorgeous, gorgeous girl she is. So if you're interested in Patch, then please hurry on down here to Animal Control and rescue this sweet girl. She's down here just waiting for you. And guys, we'll show you Emmett Brown right now. This handsome fella has found a cool spot on the floor that he is just loving laying on. He is also a black mouth cur mix. And poor guy, he's actually microchipped, but I don't know if they can't get in touch with the owner or what's going on with that situation. But this sweet, sweet boy was picked up as a stray from Hospital Road wearing a blue collar. You know, when you do get your pet microchipped, folks, you have to remember if you move or change your phone number, you have to update that with the microchip company because they have no way of finding you otherwise. So just microchipping is not enough. You need to make sure that you contact, when you're moving, you contact so many different companies. One of them should be the company that does the microchip for your pet. But Emmett Brown here is hanging out in B16. He's in one of the outside cages, so it's no wonder he's flopping down on the floor in here because it's so hot with these hot Georgia summers we've been having. And poor Emmett is just trying to cool off on this floor. I don't know his age. We know he's at least a year old, and he is heartworm negative. He's had his shots. He's been dewormed. And he is just so ready to go to a home where he can get lots of love. And poor guy, he's just crying. I mean, he's probably missing his owner, doesn't understand how in the world he ended up here. And he's just so, so confused. But he's so sweet, folks. He just needs somebody to give him lots of love, and he's going to give you so much love in return. So come on down and rescue Emmett Brown. He's down here just waiting for you. And folks, these little sweethearts are just playing and being silly and having all kinds of fun. They're little wiggle worms for sure. I am holding little John, and then our volunteer Suzanne is holding Lou. They're kind of medium-haired kitty cats. I don't think they're going to be considered short-haired. They are only about 4 months old, and they're both hanging out together in C27. Now, both of these guys, as far as we know, are siblings because they were picked up in the same place off of Heery Road. I believe it's spelled H-E-E-R-Y. They are absolutely adorable. This one's a climber. They're both climbers. They're both very active. But you know what? When you're looking to adopt a kitten, you want a kitten that's active because then you know it's healthy. If a kitten's not feeling well, it's not going to crawl around and be curious and you know, check out everything. It's just going to want to sleep all the time. And these two definitely just want to play, play, play. So if you were interested in little John, who is the tabby with white, or his brother Lou, who is jet black and just as handsome as he can be, then definitely you want to come down here to Animal Control and save these little guys. We would love to see them go together because they are siblings, but if you can't take them both, then certainly we want to make sure that they get adopted out one at a time. But come on down and take a look and meet little John or his brother Lou. I know you're going to love these little boys, and they're going to climb all over you too, and certainly climb right into your heart. And that is our show for today, folks. Thank you so very much for tuning in. As I mentioned at the very beginning of our show, our group, the Noonan Coweta Humane Society, is in the process of raising money for our first and only standalone shelter. It'll be the first no-kill shelter in Coweta County, and we're so excited about it. We're so close to our goal, and we just need you to promote you know, the fact that we're doing this. Maybe you know somebody that would love to donate, or you would like to donate. Please check out our website at nchsrescue.org to get more information. Also, just want to mention that we do have some other fundraisers coming up. We have a Fido Fest fun run. It's a 5K and it's a fun run. I believe that's going to be September 23rd. I know it's coming up in September. I believe it's the 23rd. You can get more information about that on our website as well, or you can go straight to active.com and register for that run as well. If you don't want to run, you can walk. You can also be what's called a phantom runner, and that is someone who is not able to participate but wants to get the t-shirt, and you still are able to donate to our group that way as well. So come on and check out Fido Fest, the 5K run and fun run. That's going to be at Ashley Park on September 23rd. And also, we have another fundraiser on August 31st, which is a Nukes fundraiser. That's the Nukes restaurant in Ashley Park from 5 to 8 if you want to come eat with us. The money that is raised that night will also go to our group. And we're just so excited about the things that are happening with our group, folks. We're growing. We're going to have our own standalone shelter. There are some wonderful things happening in our organization because of our volunteers and also wonderful people like you. So thank you so much for watching the show and for all that you do as well to promote our group. But I also have so many people to thank. The Coweta County Animal Control Facility that we filmed this show in, thank you so much for allowing us to come down and showcase these wonderful fur kids and fur babies that you have here for adoption. I also want to thank New Link for making this show possible, for filming it, and for sending us Laura, who is the superwoman of all camera women, the Wonder Woman of all camera women. And also want to make sure that we thank our volunteers for their time, love, and just so that you know, there is not a single person in our group that gets paid for what we do. We all get paid with purrs and puppy kisses. So if you want to find out more information about maybe volunteering with us, I know that you'll love it. You'll have lots of fun. You can find out that information on our website as well. So thank you so very much for tuning in, folks. We hope that you enjoyed the show today as much as we enjoyed bringing it to you.